I was very young, when I was 17, because my dad was a builder, I used to do all his planning drawings. Just did it on my own. His friends, you know, had bought a house, say, in Kilburn or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And then they would approach me to, can you get planning for conversion to 5 flats from this one house? Go self-taught, on. Really. And then I should have realised then I should have taken that career path, but I think my career path just went a different way. And I went into art school rather than architecture school. Very much fine art, you know. But then, you know, maybe it's just a different career move, really. Started there. I saw everyone around me as an architect, and I thought, well, I can
do this.
But of course, you know, later in life it does take you long because you've got work commitments and, you know, things like that. So you sort of, unfortunately, you know, the company helped also financially. Longer, and then the health as well, you know, so that's taken effect. And the health, in a way, took the effect that changed the path where we'd probably be more in the building trade. So I decided, well, I thought, well, maybe it's just time to sort of change my tool from a hammer to a sort of a pencil. So yeah, so that's the sort of career path, and now just, you know, I think it's just finding something that you're proud of, you know. Some architects who can sort of, with their strength and purpose, they can provide architecture which has a little bit more dynamics. The piece of canvas, isn't it? You know, the first mark is the hardest mark. Where I think it's important that you have simple architecture. Through studies, I think, and hearing other people talk about it, you can see where they sort of say to pull it back a bit, you know.